day, everyone. My name is Rosaline Perez, and for today, we are going to cook a dish for the school-age children. It is one of the most famous Filipino dishes that your children will truly love. It is simple and easy to cook. It is called tinola. But before cooking, first, you need to gather all the materials and ingredients that you needed.
Prepare your utensils, casserole, spatula, knife, peeler, and chopping board. We have your rice grains, 1/2 kilo of chicken, 1 spoon of salt, garlic, onion, ginger, and the sayote. Also, you have your nar cubes. 4 to 6 spoons of cooking oil and 3 to 4 cups of water.
After gathering all the materials and ingredients that you needed, do not forget to wear your apron and your hairnet. You do not want your child to eat the food you served with a bad stomach. Before cooking, you should always remember to wash your hands first. Washing our hands, we can now proceed in cooking the dish.
Come on. Rinse the vegetables before peeling them. Make sure that your vegetables are fresh and clean. Now you can now proceed on peeling and slicing the vegetables. Chop the garlic, onion, and ginger in a diced manner. Use the holder of your knife to crush the ginger and garlic. Caution, do not let your child play in the kitchen while you are cooking. It might cause an accident. Now, in peeling, you may start from top to bottom. The peeler should be facing away from your body. Good nutrition helps children to do better at home and in school. Growing children need more bodybuilding foods to grow fast and strong. In meal planning for children 7 to 9 years old, make green leafy and yellow vegetables and fruits a must in a daily family meals. Stimulate appetite with various forms, colors, sizes, and shapes of food served. Feeding the school child wants simple and plain dishes. Tinola is a perfect one. They eat what most adults eat. They also develop fondness for food products seen in television commercials and appetite for the favorite food of his or her celebrity idol. Tinola is one of the most widely commercialized Filipino dish. And it uses chicken meat. Who else doesn't love chicken? In slicing the sayote, you do not want it to look too small or too big. Make sure to slice it in a square pattern and medium size. Sayote is rich in nutrients. It contains calories, carbohydrates, protein, and fiber. It is also rich in vitamin C, folate, and vitamin K. Lunch is a dietary problem for school-age children because they eat their lunch in school or fast food joints. On weekends, when your child stays at home, you can cook tinola for lunch for your child to enjoy an appetizing and nutritious meal at home. It is even better if your mother cooks it for you.
Slicing the vegetables and the ingredients that you needed for cooking, we can now go to the kitchen and start cook.
Do they think, pump it, louder, come on, don't stop, and keep it going, do it, let's get it on, move it,
come on, baby, do it.
Turn on the gas stove. Focus on me. Yeah. Wait for a few seconds for the casserole to heat up, and then you can now put your cooking oil. Make sure you have your proper measurement of your cooking oil. You do not want the tinola to be greasy. Check the heat of the oil. If you think it is now ready, you can now put your onion and garlic. You can now adjust the fire of your stove to medium fire. You do not want your ingredients to get burned. Stir the onion and garlic. Then add your chicken meat. Saute the chicken. Then add the ginger. Cover it for 3 to 5 minutes. While waiting, you can now rinse the rice grains. Add salt and stir. Now you can add water. Estimate the amount of water you are going to pour. You do not want your tinola to have too much water. And if it has little amount of water, it may taste too salty. You can now add the chicken nor cubes. To add flavor to your dish, wait for it to boil for about 5 to 10 minutes. Check for the chicken meat if it is almost cooked. Now you can add the sayote. You can now start cleaning and removing used and unnecessary kitchen tools in your cooking area. Wait for it to boil for another 3 minutes for the sayote to be cooked. Once it is done, check for its final taste. Avoid spicy, too greasy, and rich flavored dishes for school-age children. Then you're good to go. Perform your aftercare. Wash all the utensils that you've used and dispose properly all your waste.
After cooking your dish, you can now clean everything that you've used while cooking, and also after performing your aftercare, Do not forget to wash your hands before cooking and after cooking. Wash your hands.
And here is our tinola. Voila! 1 cup of rice, 1 serving of sweetened banana for dessert. Our main dish, 1 serving of tinola. And a glass of water.
Do they think? Pump it, louder, come on, don't stop, and keep me going, do it. Let's get it on, move it.
Come on, baby, do it.
Thank you very much for joining me today. I hope you've learned a lot from me. I enjoyed cooking with you and see you again. Goodbye. Happy lunch. Happy lunch. Happy lunch. Here are some tips in cooking dishes for your children. First, be creative in serving them the dishes that you've cooked. You can make different cuts of your vegetables and fruits for them to get encouraged to eat it and enjoy the food by just looking at it. Second, do not serve them the same food that you've cooked yesterday and you're going to feed them again today. They will gonna lose their appetite and eventually not gonna eat that food that you served for them. And lastly, have a variety of foods. You can make a lot of simple dishes from a simple ingredient. You can cook a lot of recipes from chicken, pork, fish, also these vegetables. We have our vegetables on Bahay Kubo and they are very nutritious and very enjoying to eat if you could serve them to your child in very, very different and fun way.